What's up, y'all? It's your boy Uncle Maine on the Rogues Gallery channel. Anyway, I'm getting ready to touch up on this topic of can you outgrow a genre? And short answer, of course you can. But go ahead and comment, rate, subscribe, and I'm out. No, I'm just joking. Just joking. Alright. So anyway, can you? Of course you can. Like I said, the short answer. Me? I have, but the only time, hey, can you hear me that remote? The only times I actually, will you say, outgrow a genre is when I really can't. Let me turn all this noise down. Is when I can't even relate to it anymore. So when it's stuff like kitty type things, like we used to, I used to watch Barney. I can't watch that stuff nowadays, stuff like that. But things that I usually pick up, I would say that I wouldn't outgrow the genre because I'm more selective about what I really get into. And when I do get into it, I don't gorge. You know what I'm saying? Like a lot of people in the anime community that watch anime, whatever, they say, ooh, I watch 30,000 series. I never watched no 400 or 500 complete series. I watched how many? Maybe 50. What? Between 30 and 50, something like that series. But anything other than that, outside of that realm, and I'm talking about over a period of time, and I might have missed episodes or chapters and stuff like that in between. But all the other stuff, I might watch a couple episodes, chapters. You know, I wouldn't really try to take my time out of my day to just gorge on that stuff. That's why people get tired of it. I used to eat banana pudding every day and stop doing it. Because you get tired of it after doing it for so long. You know what I'm saying? The same thing over and over. So, anime and stuff like that, I'm really not bored because I'm really not gorging on it. I'm not reading 500 series like these other guys. I'm not doing it. I'm going to talk about music. Now, I grew up listening to hip-hop and R&B, like Game Manic said. But, like, as time went by, it wasn't that I got out of it. I'm still heavy in it. You know what I'm saying? It was the fact that I used to listen to the radio a lot. I stopped listening to it because there was nothing but garbage coming out on the radio, man. All this pop tune garbage and all that Justin Bieber type music and stuff like that, I'm not into that. And that's all that comes on nowadays. Hip-hop went that way. R&B went that way. And there's nothing wrong with pop. I like pop. But it's when they lower the quality and they just make a catchy tune or something like that. A nice beat or something like that, and that's they think that's all that they need to sell their album with. And then they got albums with one or two good songs, and that's it. And you got to keep putting on repeat or keep skipping between two or three songs at the most. I don't like that. I like to put my CDs on and just play them. That thank God for the MP3 player. That's what got me out of the darkness and into the light. I just listen, like, nowadays, I might catch a song on the radio, but usually I won't like it because a lot of times it's just gimmicks and stuff like that. But if I do like it, I gotta actually really like it. If I really like it, I'll put it on my MP3 player. That's what the MP3 player is for. A lot of people put all the new stuff, you know, from the radio. You can listen to that on the radio. I don't put anything on there unless I know I'm gonna be listening to it for a very, very long time, you know what I'm saying? The stuff I got on it now, the stuff I got on it now, I'm convinced that that's the stuff I'm going to be listening to when I'm 90 years old, you know what I'm saying? I'm more so listening to, damn, that flew past. Okay, but anyway, I'm more into 80s and 90s music. And also, I like what Larry said, Motown, stuff like that, you know, old school, you know, like classic music. But that's not like my mainstay, so I didn't put them on my MP3 player, but I do listen to them from time to time. But like this new stuff, like a lot of people, they into that Lil Wayne. I can't get into Lil Wayne. I like two or three of his songs. I think Lil Wayne's a lot of gimmick and stuff like that. He got, and I ain't gonna lie, he got a nice little flow, whatever. He got a few songs I like. And I do respect him as an artist, though, because I see, like, on Behind the Music, stuff like that, I see what type of, you know, artist he is, and he's a good artist. But a lot of that stuff that he makes is, like, pop tune, garbage, you know, stuff like that, just trying to, you know, sell gimmick, and I don't like that. A lot of the quality in music nowadays is gone, you know what I'm saying? Just throw, you know, somebody go ahead and get a beat made, throw that together, and then they just rap on it or whatever. And it's all off topic. They don't have a topic that they're talking about in the songs. I don't like that. So that's why I don't listen to a lot of music nowadays. I'm more selective in music, too. I'm more selective in everything I do. I don't really gorge myself on things. Like I said, I listen to more so 80s and 90s. Rock. I listen to rock. I really like rock, but only I don't like that heavy metal crap. That sounds like crap to me. Like a lot of people say, hip hop sounds like a bunch of noise. Heavy metal sounds like a bunch of noise to me. I can't stand it. I like soft rock and stuff like that. I listen to like Pat Benatar, Phil Collins and stuff like that. That's the type of rock I listen to. Yeah, that's what I'm into. I ain't into all that. Somebody made me listen to some black metal. I can't take that satanic crap. You know what I'm saying? So, the genres I listen to now, I'm pretty sure I'm going to listen to them throughout the rest of my life. But I don't gorge myself on it so that I won't just get sick and tired of it. But it's more so not the genre. It's more so me being like the things I did grow out of. Like, I'm not watching Barney now. You know what I'm saying? Those things is because I'm in a completely different stage of life where I don't think that I can even relate to that kind of stuff. You know what I'm saying? That kind of stuff. I still watch Power Rangers, but very selectively. I used to watch it religiously. Like, when I was a kid, I watched it when I could catch it. Whenever I could catch it, I used to watch it. But then when I grew up, like when I was like 14 or something like that, I watched it religiously, even though the quality was less because I actually had the time. Before, I didn't even have the time. I was out doing things. But when I finally had the time, around 14, I was watching it religiously. You know? Religiously. But now I don't. I watch it when I get the chance or when I got the time or if it's a episode I didn't see. You know what I'm saying? And you know, but Smallville, I got into that because my sister, she told me about it. I said Superman show. I said, I know they're going to mess it up. It's going to be him just flying around saving people. She said, no, it ain't like that, blah, blah, blah. I watched it. Then what happened is, this is another way people get out of certain genres. I didn't watch one episode by accident. I missed one episode because I was out or something like that. Then I missed another episode. Then, let's say I know I wasn't even watching it. I didn't even see the series finale, which I need to see. I didn't see that. I'm going to have to see that stuff. But after a while of missing something, you just can't get back into it. You know what I'm saying? Even if you like it. And I like Smallville. But what was the last place I left off? When, what you call them, Lex had a clone. But before that, the clone turned evil, came back, and he was old with him. But before that, I missed a whole bunch of episodes before that. The Justice League episode, that was the last one I watched. The one when, I started missing a lot of episodes, so I couldn't even watch it. And then when you come back in, it's like you missed so much, it's hard to get back into. So you can grow out of a out of genres like that. But the genres I'm into, pretty much, I think I'm gonna be in it for life, for life, basically. So the music I listen to now, hip hop, R&B, rock. I'm in the old school type of music, stuff like that, 80s, 90s, a few 70s songs, stuff like that. That's what I think I'm going to be listening to that for pretty much the rest of my life. So those type of things I'm not going to outgrow. I think I'm only going to outgrow stuff if it's so different, you know, so different from where I am today that I can't listen to it. Then that's when I think I'll grow something. It's not a lot of things that I really get into like that where I just, you know, just can't relate to it. Music-wise, what was I used to, for a minute, I was listening to, like, hip-hop heavy. I mean, heavy. I mean, I put the genre on hip-hop and just listened to that for a long time. Then after a minute, me gorging on it, I got sick. I said, man, I can't listen to it. Put on R&B. I gorged on that. Then I said, no, okay, let me listen to rock. Listen to that. You know, Love is a Battlefield and all that type of stuff. Love is a Battlefield and all that kind of stuff. I'm listening to that. And sooner or later, I said, man, I can't listen to this. And I started listening to something else. But I came back to all that stuff. So pretty much that's it. Go ahead and subscribe to the Rogue Scholarly Inc. And my information is in the description box if you want to know. And that's it. Peace.